15 years ago. If there would have been a Jewish state in Palestine when Hitler appeared on the horizon and came to power, a state and a country which would have opened its gate to all the Jews who had to come to escape, this tragedy wouldn't have occurred. Everybody understands this. This is elementary. And therefore I say that certainly we have the right to insist this time, after the lives of 5 million Jews have proved to the world what the Jewish problem means. You don't have today to preach Zionism or to read Herzl and Pinsker and Hess and Ahadam. You just have to say 5 million Jews massacred in Europe because of the homelessness of the Jewish people. We have certainly the right to demand that the world shouldn't wait for a second lesson of this kind till it will implement the principle which was recognized even formally and internationally long before Hitler, namely to give Palestine to the Jewish people as a real national home. We have waited 20 years with its implementation. I think we have proved in Palestine that we are in a position to build up the Jewish national home and run our own affairs and establish our own commonwealth. And the Jewish position, the diaspora, has proven with the lives of 5 million Jews how urgently necessary it is. And therefore, this World Jewish Congress session, not being a Zionist body in its constitution, cannot begin even its deliberations without proclaiming the principle that no real solution of the Jewish problem, even in granting all these other demands, which are nothing else than the application of the general principle of equality for the Jews, that the real solution of the Jewish problem cannot be brought about unless the Jewish people will be given the right and will be helped by the United Nations to establish Palestine once and for all as its own Jewish homeland. To add one other demand. It is a formal demand of procedure, but it is very essential. It's a question not only of practical necessity, but of moral dignity for the Jewish people. The demand for Jewish representation. We are beginning to be very tired of having to sit alone among all the peoples of the world, permanently in the waiting rooms and the corridors of the State Departments and the Foreign Offices. We don't mind sitting around there. Here you have one to my left who has spent much of his time in these corridors and in the rooms, office rooms of the State Department of the world. But we must insist that this shouldn't be the only place where Jewish representatives are permitted to present their demands. We want to be allowed to sit around the tables where the vital questions of our future will be discussed and determined upon. We know that we don't represent the government, and we never asked for the same they make. But taken as a whole, the existence of this de facto Jewish commonwealth, as I call it, the commonwealth without being recognized yet as such, of this great Jewish community running its own affairs, having this feeling of freedom, of independence, feeling able and in a position to take care not only of itself, but of many other parts of the suffering communities of the Jewish people. This too is one of the main elements which allow a Jew, without just being blind, to maintain its hope and its faith in the Jewish future. But it means also, as I say, it means strengthened and greater and heavier responsibilities. And I say this especially to our Jewish colleagues and delegates from the Western Hemisphere. The fact that this is the first international Jewish conference in the Western Hemisphere. It is my privilege to present the resolution on Palestine. The War Emergency Conference of the World Jewish Congress associates itself with the program of the Jewish Agency for Palestine and its claim that in the new democratic era, assuring peace, freedom, and equality among nations, there must be a definitive and permanent solution of the national homelessness of the Jewish people by the establishment of Palestine as a Jewish Commonwealth. The conference appeals to the United Nations to ensure that the general scheme of post-war reconstruction shall include the establishment of Palestine as a free and democratic Jewish Commonwealth, and that appropriate public financial and other resources be provided for that purpose, including the speedy transfer to Palestine of all Jewish survivors of Nazi persecution who desire or need to have part in the rebuilding of the Jewish national home. I present the resolution on Palestine. The War Emergency Conference of the World Jewish Congress associates itself with the program of the Jewish Agency for Palestine and its claims that in the new democratic era, assuring peace, freedom, and equality among nations, there must be a definitive and permanent termination of the national homelessness of the Jewish people by the establishment. This conference urges the British government to abrogate the policy set out in the White Paper of 1939 and to open Palestine to unrestricted Jewish immigration and resettlement. This conference appeals to the United Nations to ensure that the general scheme of post-war reconstruction shall include the establishment of Palestine as a free and democratic Jewish Commonwealth, and that appropriate public, financial, and other resources be provided for that purpose, including the speedy transfer to Palestine of all Jewish survivors of Nazi persecution who desire or need to have part in the rebuilding of the Jewish national home.
The youngest delegate from Chile.
And be fairly serious, this will be cut in over Dr. Wise's speech at the time. And when I give you the signal with the handkerchief, I'd like your applauding. I mean, just be serious, so no smiling at the moment. Everybody looking right here. Well, we have your applauding, please. May everybody applauding now?